Let's start unit number 3, sequential logic circuits. Right. Generally, logic circuits are classified into main two groups. One is combinational logic circuit and second is sequential logic circuit. Right. In previous lecture, we have discussed about combinational logic circuit. In this chapter, we are going to learn about sequential logic circuits. Right. So, this is simple block diagram for combinational logic circuit, right? Combinational logic circuit block, it has inputs and outputs, right? So output of combinational logic circuit is depend only on present input, right? And you can see sequential logic circuit block diagram, right? In sequential circuit, memory element is present, right? Along with combinational logic. So output of sequential logic circuit is depend on present input, right? Present input and previous output, right? Which is stored in memory. Output of sequential circuit is depend on present input and previous output, which is stored in memory element, right? Combinational logic circuit has simple logic gates. Right, basic building blocks are logic gates, while basic building blocks of sequential logic circuit are flip-flops. Right. Okay, difference between combinational logic circuit and sequential logic circuit. In combinational circuit, the output variables at any instant of time are dependent only on the present input variable, right? You can see in block diagram output is depend only on present inputs. In sequential circuit, the output variables at any instant of time are dependent not only on present inputs variable but also past output variables, right? Memory unit is not required in combinational circuit, means memory unit is absent in combinational circuit. Memory unit is required to store the past history. Memory element is present in sequential circuit. Combinational circuits are faster because the delay between the input and output is due to propagation delay of gates only, while sequential circuits are slower than combinational circuit. Combinational circuits are easy to design, while sequential circuits are comparatively harder to design. Okay. Basic memory cell. Right. What is exactly memory? What is memory? A memory should support at least three operations. Right. Memory should support at least three operation. First, it should be able to hold a value, means it is able to store a bit, right? Binary bit. You should be able to read the value that is saved, right? You should be able to read the value that is saved, and you should be able to change that value. So memory should perform at this three operations. We will start with simple case and a 1-bit memory. It should be able to hold a single bit. It may be either 0 or 1. Right, 1-bit memory should be able to hold 1 bit, and as a bit it should be 0 or 1. You should be able to read the bit that is saved. You should be able to change the bit. You can set the bit to 0 or you can reset or clear the bit to 0. So these are the operation which should be performed by memory. How can a circuit remember anything when it is just a bunch of gates that produce output according to input, right? The idea is to be make a loop in a circuit so output are also inputs. Suppose consider a simple loop circuit. Simple loop circuit, right? Bistable means this circuit has two states. Bistable, bi means two. This circuit has two stable states. So if the input of first NOT gate is 1, then output will be 0. This output is applied to second NOT gate, so again output will be 1, right? So this phenomena continuously happen, and it will store output 1, right? So to store a bit in simple manner, we need minimum 2 NOT gates, right? 2 inverters are feedback loop from a static storage cell. The cell will hold value as long as it has power applied, right? It will store a bit up to what time? Till we will apply power. How to get a new value into a storage cell? Suppose in this circuit we are storing bit 1, right? So if we want to change its value, then how to get a new value into the storage cell? So selectively break feedback path and load new value into cell. So break the feedback path, right? So here you can see feedback is open circuit, then load new value into cell. So by using this switch we can load new value, right? So suppose if we will apply 0, if we will apply 0 at input, then output, if we will apply 0 at input, then output of first NOT gate is 1. So this one is applied at second NOT gate, so output of NOT gate will be again 0, right? So this time this circuit holding bit 0, right? This time this circuit holding bit 0. So in this manner we can change stored value. One bit memory cell. The output of each gate is connected to the input of the other gate. Output of each gate is connected to the input of other gate. Right. So this output of Q is connected to input of Q bar gate, and output of second gate is connected to the input of first gate. This feedback connection is known as flip flop. Right. This feedback connection is known as flip flop. So our next topic is flip flop. So why those circuits are called flip flop? Because the output of each gate is connected to the input of the other gate. So that's why that connection is known as flip flop. So one bit memory cell has two stable states which are known as 1 or high or logic 1 state and 0 low state. Since flip flop has two stable state, it is called a binary or bistable. Flip flop has two stable states, so it is called binary or bistable. Similarly, it stores one bit information either 1 or 0. Means one flip flop can hold one bit. One flip flop can store one bit. As a one bit, either it is 1 or high or 0 or low. It is a one bit memory unit or one bit storage cell. Flip flop is one bit memory unit or one bit storage cell. So if we want to store one byte, then how many flip flops are required to store 1 byte? 1 byte is equal to 8 bits. So to store 1 byte or 8 bits, we required total 8 number of flip-flops. Since information is locked or latched, 1 bit memory cell is also known as latch. We will see what is latch. Latch are the bistable device which responds to the change of input logic level as they occur. Right? This is latch, two inputs and two outputs. Both outputs are complement of each other. Q is primary output and Q bar is its complementary output. Means two possible outputs are there, either 0 or 1. So if Q is equal to 0, then Q bar must be 1. If Q is 1, then Q bar must be 0, because both outputs are complement of each other. It is said to be in set state if output Q is high, and it is said to be reset state if Q is low. Means two possible outputs are there, either Q is equal to 0 or Q is equal to 1. So whenever Q will be 1, the latch is set. Whenever Q will be 1, latch is set. And whenever Q will be 0, latch is reset. Right? Set means 1, reset means 0. So whenever output is 1, latch is set. And whenever output is 0, latch is reset. RS or SR latch using NOR gate. So first of all, what is latch? Latch is one type of flip-flop, has no clock pulse, right? There are two memory elements. First is latch and second is flip-flop. What is difference between latch and flip-flop? Flip-flop has clock pulse, clock input, while latch has no clock input. This is simple logic diagram for SR latch using NOR gate only, right? You can see only NOR gate are present. So this is simple circuit diagram or logic diagram, right? SR or RS. RS stand for reset set, right? R stand for reset and S stand for set. This is simple symbol of SR latch. Two inputs, two outputs. Two outputs are Q and Q bar. Two inputs are R and S. So inputs, outputs. Simple symbol of SR latch. You can say SR or RS. So this is truth table for SR latch, right? Two inputs, so total how many possibilities? Four possibilities. But sequential circuit, output of sequential circuit is depend on present input, right? Present inputs are R and S, and previous output Q and Q bar. So if we will consider Q is equal to 0, then Q bar will be 1. And if we are considering Q is equal to 1, then Q bar must be 0. So consider only Q, right? Don't consider Q bar, only Q, because if Q is equal to 0, then Q bar will be 1. So you can derive outputs from this circuit. So in truth table, two inputs S R, right? Two inputs S R. These both inputs are present input, right? Q N is past output, previous output. Q N plus one is next output or next state, right? You can say present state. These both are present state. This one is previous state and next state or next output. Qn and n plus 1 means next state, right? Here n plus 1 means next state, Qn is previous state, n plus 1 is next state. So present inputs are R and S. So two inputs, total how many possibilities? 4. This is first possibility 0 0, second possibility 0 1, third possibility 1 0, fourth possibility 1 1. Right. So output of sequential circuit is depend on present input and previous output. So previous output means Q. Right, previous output Q. So here we are considering Qn. So previous output may be 0 or 1. Previous output may be 0 or 1. So you can see for each possibility of inputs, here 0 and 1 both are considered. Right, for 0, 0, previous output 0 and 1. For 0, 1, previous output 0, 1, 1, 0. Previous output 0 1 and for 1 1 previous output 0 and 1. So let's consider first input possibility S0 R0 Qn 0 S0 R0 Q 0. So if Q is equal to 0, then Q bar must be 1. So this is NOR gate. NOR gate input 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1. Output of NOR gate is 1 0 0 0. Output of NOR gate. If both inputs are 0, output will be 1, else output will be 0. So R0, S0, Q0, Q0, so Q bar must be 1. So this 0 is feedback to, this is gate number 1, gate number 2. Logic 0 is feedback to gate number 2. So 0, S is equal to 0. Both input of gate number 2 are 0. So output will be 1. So output will be 1. This one is previously considered output. And this one is feedback to gate 1. So 1 is feedback to gate 1. This 0, R is equal to 0. So 0, 1, 0. So 0, right? So you can see previously considered output 0, next output 0, previously considered output 1, next output 1, right? So Q is, if we are considering Q is equal to 0, then next output will be 0. So here Qn plus 1 0. Right, for second case 0 0 Qn 1, second case 0 0 Q 1, so Q bar will be 0. This 0 is feedback to this gate and 1 is feedback to second gate. So 0 1, output of NOR gate will be 0. This 0 is already feedback to the gate 1, so again 0 0, right? This R is equal to 0. 0 0 1, so 1 1 is already feedback to gate 2, so now our latch is in stable. So if we are considering Q is equal to 1, then output or next state output is also 1. So for S is equal to 0, R is equal to 0, and Qn is equal to 1, Q Qn plus 1 means next state output is 1. So this case is called no change. Why no change? If we are comparing Qn with Qn plus 1, then there is no change. If previously considered output is 0, then next state is also 0, and previously considered output 1, then next state 1. So this case is called no change. Similarly, you can try for 0, 1, for Qn is equal to 0 and Qn is equal to 1. In this case, you will get 0, 0. For both cases, you will get 0, 0. So if Qn plus 1 is equal to 0, then that state is called reset, right? Because output are 0. For 1, 0, Qn plus is equal to 1. So it is known as set condition, right? And for 1, 1, here you can see don't care, right? So it is known as intermediate, or it is called invalid state, because both state, let's see in circuit diagram. If Q is equal to 0, right, Q is equal to 0, then Q bar must be 1. But in 1, 1 case, we will get both inputs same. Either both are 0 or both are 1. And that case is not valid case, right? If Q is equal to 0, then Q bar must be 1. Or if Q is equal to 1, then Q bar must be 0. But when we are applying 1, 1 at both input, then we will get same output at both out Q and Q bar. So that case is invalid case. Right, that case is invalid case. So here in the in second possibility, S is equal to 0, R is equal to 1, our latch is in reset condition, or our latch will be reset, right? So R stands for reset. So if we will apply 1 at R and 0 at S, 1 at R and 0 at S, then our latch will be reset, right? આપણને ખબર છે કે આપણે કોઈના પર પણ 1 આપીએ તો એ એક્ટિવ થાય, બરાબર ને? 0 આપીએ તો એ ડિસેબલ થાય, ને 1 આપીએ તો એનેબલ થાય. સો ઇફ વી વિલ ગીવ 1 એટ આર, ધેન રીસેટ કન્ડિશન વિલ એક્ટિવ. ઇન થર્ડ કેસ, એસ ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ 1, આર ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ 0. એસ ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ 1, આર ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ 0. સો સેટ કન્ડિશન વિલ એનેબલ, બરાબર ને? એસ પર 1 આપીએ તો સેટ કન્ડિશન એનેબલ થાય. સો હિયર અવર લેચ વિલ સેટ. એન્ડ ઇન ફોર્થ કેસ, 1 1 ઇનડિટરમાઇન ઓર ઇનવેલિડ સ્ટેટ. નેક્સ્ટ, આર એસ લેચ યુઝિંગ NAND ગેટ. RS latch using NAND gate. Symbol is same, just NOR gate is replaced by NAND gate. Just function is little bit change. In previous in 0-0 condition, when both inputs are 0, then our state or output is no change. And for 1-1, our output is intermediate. While using NAND gate, 0-0, if both inputs are 0-0, then our state is indeterminate. And for both input 1, our output is no change, or our state is no change. and RS ledge using NAND with additional circuitry. Right here you can see two NOT gate using NAND gates are placed in the both R and S input. Right, two NOT gate. Right, this is NOT gate using NAND gate. So NOT gate are placed in input. So we will get exactly same output. Like RS ledge using NOT, no change, reset, set, indeterminate, right? So no change, reset, set, and indeterminate, right? So SR ledge using NAND with additional circuitry. As additional circuit, we are placing two NOT gate in both inputs. Symbol is same, right? Let's consider one case. Suppose Q is equal to 0, so Q bar must be 1, R is equal to 0, S is equal to 0. So this is NOT gate, so output will be 1. Again, output will be 1. This 0 is feedback to NAND gate, second NAND gate, and this one is feedback to first NAND gate. So both inputs are 1 and this in 0 and 1. So 0 and 1, so output will be 1 because this is NAND gate. So 1 remain 1 and this one is feedback to first gate. So 1 1 0, so output will be 0. Already 0 is feedback to gate number 2, so output will be 1. So now our latch is in stable position, so 0 remain 0 and 1 remain 1. So means 0 0 when both inputs are 0, then next output will be 0. So this is no change condition. If you are performing same procedure here, then you will get these states. So this is truth table for RH ledge using NAND gate with additional circuitry.